Out of heart, we knew this was going to be a big game, and you know, we knew they would be excited to play. And that second half, we really stepped it up. I mean, we kind of came out a little slow, but between really every position, Colin, McClelland stepped up huge for us. I mean, Eric Scott, it was, you know, team win tonight, and we're excited. So, but you know, we got to move on to the next one. So.
As part of that midfield, what's it like feeding guys like Eric and Scott and Cody, who can almost score a will?
Right. It's awesome to know the feeling that you have guys like that who can score from really any part of the field and who you can count on when you run down the field for the fast break. I mean, it's unreal.
Makes your job easy. Makes it easy. Just throw it up there and then...
So you guys remain undefeated, the only unbeaten team left in the county. Did you guys know going in how Hebron was undefeated, and was that kind of a chip on your guys' shoulder?
I mean, yeah, we definitely had a chip on our shoulder. We try to keep a chip on our shoulder for basically every opponent, knowing that they're going to come out with their all. And we knew, especially for this game, them being undefeated, it was just a huge game for us. And we laid it all out on the field. And I'm really happy about the performance today.
Cool, man. Thank
you. McClelland, just talk about you guys defensively, what you guys were able to do out there. I mean, that's a pretty good Mount Hebron team that you guys defeated tonight.
Yeah, I mean, we have three great Polish shots, Federer, Adam Friedman, and Marshall McGlone, who can shut down a bunch of people. They're great Poles, and they're great to have in front of you. I mean, Mount Hebron has great shooters. They're a great team, and we were able to do what we needed to do. We had a great scout going out for them, and we were able to execute our scout and then do what we needed to do in order to keep them below.
Hey, Schroeder, come on in here, man. Get some of this right here. Just talk about just what you guys did offensively tonight. I mean, just... pedal to the metal. This was a big week for you guys, I know, with Falston and tonight's game, and you guys came out flying colors.
So what I think happens if we don't score within the first 2 minutes of the game, we'll come out very slow like we did in this game. It was sort of close in the first quarter and pulled away, but once we get a couple in the net, a couple past Casey, great goalie, that we start running, we don't slow down.
Right. Just talk about the effort, especially the second half, man. You guys were just... raising your level, just kind of like...
We've been working every single day since September, and in this type of game, it pays off. When some teams don't do that, but we're a very good program that does it every single day.
Right. So. Just talk about being part of just a potent offense. I mean, so many guys out there can score. I mean...
So it's hard, because one game you'll have six goals, the next game you'll have zero goals, but the kid next to you's got six. So... You can't think about that. You just got to know that the team's winning. You can't have any individual players. We play as a team. And I think that we've got one of the best attack lines in the state and one of the best offenses in the state.
Right. Moving forward, I know everything looks peachy right now, but I'm sure there's things you guys need to fine-tune these next couple of weeks.
Definitely need to fine-tune rushing it. Sometimes we come down, we throw the ball away after the defense works so hard. Colin made a great save. But I think if we play our game, we slow down. We push transition, but if we slow down a little bit, look for the second look, not the first one, I think we'll have success.
Right, cool. Hey, congratulations, guys.